Russia carried out an anti-satellite missile test on Monday, destroying one of its own satellites in orbit. U.S. Space Command said Russia tested a direct-ascent anti-satellite, or DA-ASAT, missile. The missile struck the satellite, named Cosmos 1408, blowing it to pieces. James Dickinson, commander of U.S. Space Command, said in a statement, "Russia's tests of direct-ascent anti-satellite weapons clearly demonstrate that Russia continues to pursue counter-space weapons systems that undermine strategic stability and pose a threat to all nations." The test created a vast cloud of debris that continues to orbit Earth, and some of the material loomed dangerously close to the International Space Station. This forced astronauts to take shelter in a pair of spacecraft, a SpaceX Crew Dragon capsule and a Russian Soyuz capsule, that are capable of returning them to Earth in case of any eventualities. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Russian anti-satellite weapon is a major threat for the U.S. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Any anti-satellite weapon test is dangerous because of fallout from it. U.S. Secretary of State Antony J. Blinken, in a statement on Monday, described the missile strike as recklessly conducted. "The test has so far generated over 1,500 pieces of trackable orbital debris and will likely generate hundreds of thousands of pieces of smaller orbital debris," he added. The U.S. Space Command said in a statement that the debris will remain in orbit for years and potentially for decades, posing a significant risk to the crew on the International Space Station and other human spaceflight activities. NASA and Roscosmos, which jointly manage the space station and are responsible for the astronauts inside, have cooperated in spite of the military tensions between Washington and Moscow. Things seem to have deteriorated because of Monday's weapon test. Bill Nelson, NASA's administrator, said in an interview, "This is pitiful that the Russians would do this." He said NASA officials have talked to Russia's space agency, Roscosmos, about the anti-satellite test. Satellites are one of the most important assets for a nation. They play a vital role in civilian and military communications. Military satellites are used for gathering intelligence, as well as they can monitor and provide early warning against missile launches by a rival nation. Military satellites also provide precise guidance to missiles, aircraft, and warships, to name a few. So, if satellites of a particular nation are destroyed, it will become handicapped in a conflict. This is why the anti-satellite weapon is seen as a key military capability by the world. The U.S. was the first to possess this kind of capability. It carried out its first ASAT test in 1959. The Soviet Union, after conducting a series of 7 tests from 1963 to 1971, declared its system operational in 1973. In January 2007, China successfully destroyed a defunct Chinese weather satellite, FY-1C. As per reports, the mission was executed by an SC-19 ASAT missile with a kinetic kill warhead. In a national address last year, Indian Prime Minister Modi said India had achieved a historic feat by shooting down its own low-orbit satellite with a ground-launched missile in 3 minutes. So, as of now, there are only 4 countries, the US, Russia, China, and India, that have demonstrated this kind of capability. France, Israel, and the UK are also thought to possess this capability. Russia has now demonstrated that it has 2 different types of space weapons. As reported, the first type of kinetic weapon is a DA-ASAT system, capable of destroying satellites in low Earth orbit, which they have tested multiple times. If this weapon is tested on an actual satellite or used operationally, it will cause large space debris that could endanger commercial satellites and pollute the space domain. The second type is a co-orbital ASAT, a space-based weapon system which demonstrated an on-orbit kinetic weapon in 2017 and again in 2020. U.S. Space Command added that in March 2018, Russian President Vladimir Putin announced the development of a ground-based laser system for use by the Russian Space Forces, which the Russian military acknowledged as a combat labor system. As per the U.S. military, this pattern of behavior would be considered potentially threatening in any other domain. It's clear that the Russian endeavor is a challenge for the US and NATO, as lots of military assets are dependent on satellite communication. Apart from immediate consequences like resulting in a major mishap at the International Space Station, there are long-term ramifications. US military has increased its footprint in space in recent years, which includes the creation of the US Space Force as a separate branch of the armed forces. If these activities continue unhindered, it will only further intensify competition among the major space players, potentially leading to the weaponization of space. The failure of the major space powers to address this in a proactive manner and agree upon a future path will be detrimental when it comes to having space as a safe and sustainable domain going forward. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.